Mr. Lincoln, in his speech this week, a very emotional speech, said, don't be afraid, don't be afraid that bilingual signs would erode the French language. Why didn't you listen to him?
Because I believe there is a consensus among Quebecers. Because of our vulnerable situation now, that if we are back to bilingual signs, I would say to equal signs, in North America, we cannot be on an equal footing with English, because, of course, now there's a law preventing signs externally, but culturally, you have the support of a quarter of a billion people in North America, and we are less than 2%. And English is the commercial language, that's the business language, all over North America. So we need legal protection. And if we have bilingual signs, that means more or less a threat of anglicization of the French situation, the French face of Quebec, of Montreal. And we want to keep Montreal as mainly a French-speaking, not exclusively, but as mainly a French-speaking city, because that's the heart of Quebec. But we want to work with all the other communities, the English-speaking communities, and that's why the government is trying to solidify the CEGEPs, the English-speaking CEGEP, the universities, the hospital. I mentioned Bill 142.
But what about rights? Mr. Lincoln also said rights or rights or rights. What do you say about that?
What I'm saying is that I have to face the real life. There's the ideal. We all agree with principle, with ideal, but I have to face the real life as leader of Quebec. And I am the only leader in North America responsible to a French-speaking majority. I have a popular mandate. I have a mandate from the people to protect French culture. If I don't do it, who will do? For French-speaking Quebecers, collective rights is essential for the survival, the progress of Quebec. So, clash of fundamental value. But I have on my desk last week a Supreme Court judgment. And whether it is impossible or possible to find a solution, I had to find one. And I find one which was an improvement for the English-speaking community. They were prohibited to advertise now in their stores, now with some, of course, regulations, they could do it.
Do you feel in any way that you're compromising yourself at all? You said this week it was a very difficult decision for you to make.
I know it's asking an extraordinary concession to the English-speaking community on grounds of principle. Practically, they are used to that prohibition. There's an improvement inside, at least. But on grounds of principle, it's an extraordinary concession. I realize that. It's tough. It was a tough time for me to take that decision, but I had to take it. And what was the other options? The statu quo? I don't think I could do that because I have to take into account the Supreme Court judgment. Bilingual signs? That will be tough. You see the problem I have now with the French-speaking people, with my solution?
Just
walk around the street. You will see the reaction of the French-speaking people. They are not happy at all.
We're talking about a few people that broke a few glass plate windows and an opposition which is ineffectual.
No, there is a deep cultural insecurity. You know, my assessment is based on my caucus. I have members all over Quebec coming from all regions. And a lot of them had to explain to their people my formula. It's not popular, maybe, with the English-speaking community. I don't believe, maybe I'm wrong, I hope not, I don't believe it's very popular also with the French-speaking people. Because moderate solution and language question are the most criticized. So I had to face that. I'm used to face challenges, and I did it.
In 1989, just around the corner, possibly an election year, what do you have to offer to Anglophone Quebecers like myself?
I would say, compared with the past, we will have relatively positive relation with the rest of Canada. Of course, now it's difficult, but that will pass. I have good relations with most provincial premiers, with the federal government, economic growth. I think they are interested for their youth, and I hope the youth of Quebec, the English-speaking youth, will understand the situation in Quebec now. We need the English-speaking youth to stay here.
So you feel good about your compromise then today?
I feel that's the best solution I could find, taking into account the circumstances. And if you consider the other options, I'm quite at ease to challenge anybody to find a better solution. If they can't, I hope they will understand me.
Thank you, Mr. Premier.
Good night.